Hi guys, it's your girl Natalie, the one true diamond, coming at you guys with Morning Chit Chat. It's Friday, and I am ready for the weekend, baby. No, I'm not really, because I think I gotta babysit my grandboys. I'm not ready for the weekend. Oh, one thing, it'll be two of them, and they are a handful. Oh my goodness. TJ likes to just walk and pull things out. Every toy he can find, he's pulling and touching, and he's steady walking. He never sits still. Never sits still. Now, Jamari, if you can find him a good cartoon, he'll be kind of, yeah, you can kind of reel him in a little bit. But anyway, excuse me for sucking snot. I know that was nasty. TMI, nasty. Nasty. I know. I can't help it. I got a baby breathing dog. Okay. So, it's Friday. And I don't know. I do want to finish up my deals, and I need to finish them up. Excuse me. Today, especially if I'm going to have them the weekend, because I can't do anything. I can't keep on with children and concentrate. So yeah. So I need to probably go ahead, because I want to do that diaper deal one more time. The Huggies deal at Rite Aid. But I got to get another card. So I need to work on getting a different card. I need to, so that I can do it and pray that the store that I'm getting my card at, so I can do it all in one sweep, has Huggies. So yeah. So I'm going to do that this afternoon after work. And then I need to clean the house, since I'll have them the weekend. I won't be able to do it, which that is in my planner, to do some housework tonight and do some tomorrow morning was my plans. And then I was going to hit the street Saturday afternoon, finishing up the last minute deals. And if there was any early activation deals, then I was going to try to incorporate that into Sunday, because my plans are to get up and go to church on Sunday. Now, if I have the boys and if I keep them overnight, I don't think I'm going to make it to church, because it's just hard to manage and enjoy a service with. Now, see, when I had my kids, I could do it because they were disciplined. They knew you're going to listen and you're going to sit down, because we're in church. Don't move. Listen. But I don't know how they're going to act, because, you know what I'm saying, they've never been in church with me, so I don't know. I really don't. The way little TJ likes to walk around and move, I don't see him sitting still. Maybe I'll go somewhere that has a children's church and put them in there, sign them in there, and my number will probably be flashing on the screen. Yeah, those are mine. That's my child's number right there flashing on the screen. Oh, God. So, I don't know how that'll go, but we'll see. And let me say, I was trying to think, I'm sorry I'm umming so much, I'm trying to think, it was something else I was going to talk about this morning. Oh, an idea. Y'all know I had talked about in previous Morning Chit Chat about the Pandora bracelets that the nurses on the job had, and everybody bringing their bracelet, and I'm like, oh, I want one. Especially when I saw the little cross and the Bible, the one with the little Bible. It looked like a little Bible to me, and the nurses one with the, for the nurse, and I'm like, okay, I gotta have one of those. So I saw where Love from Fit to Love Me was doing a challenge with her, well, not doing a challenge, but kind of motivating herself with a Pandora bracelet, that for each 10 pounds she was going to get a charm to add to her bracelet. So I want one. I'm thinking about doing one, and I think that was a great idea that I could encourage myself to motivate myself to stay on track with this weight loss, so that I, because I want a Pandora bracelet, I'm gonna get one. I already told Derek I want one, so I foresee. He said we'll see, maybe like that. So that meant I'm gonna get it. He probably say, "No, you're not. Don't be so sure of yourself." Yeah. So anyway, he's held out so far on my matching wallet though, because he, for my Coach bag, I just got. He's held out on that one. So, you know, I think he thinks it's senseless because I already got one that could go with that bag, but I just want another one. So, you know, he's like, "Nat, you know, you said you got things to do. We got things we're trying to do. You can't." I'm like, sometimes you're forced of reason and you just want to lock up in a box somewhere. Don't want a soundproof box so you don't have to hear your voice of reasoning. So I'm like, yeah, you're right. So I don't know, but I think I'll get the Pandora bracelet though. Maybe for Valentine's Day, because that's coming up. Y'all think I can talk him into it by Valentine's Day to start me one? If a good sale come up, I can. And I know this one girl on the job told me that sometimes, usually around Valentine's Day, they will put a sale up where you'll get a a bracelet and two charms to start out with for a good, decent price. So, yeah, that's what I'm looking for too. So I'll get that. That'll be my initial one. And I don't know if I'm going to go 10. I don't know if I better go 10 pounds. Maybe I should, because they say those charms are not cheap. I haven't invested in them or investigated or even looked it up to see. But they say those charms are not cheap, what the girls were telling me that have them at the job. So they most definitely will have to be a goal. So maybe 10 pounds is not unreasonable for to treat yourself for a goal, because that will probably come along. If you lose it, like 2 pounds a week, then like a month and a half, you probably could basically treat yourself to a charm if you wanted to, you know, kind of thing. So yeah, so we will see how that goes. I don't know. If I start one, I'll definitely do a video and let you guys know if I do start in on that. Now, I plan on getting me one, but I want to ask for every charm I want right from the get-go. I want to say, okay, I want this one, this one, this one, and this one, and this one. Yeah, get all this together with the... I don't want to start out with no one or two charms. I want all what I want right then. Oh Lord, okay. I'm not being silly, I'm being honest, you know me. I don't like to wait. See, look, it just takes forever. You gotta wait forever to fill your thing up. And then for every 10 pounds, woo, maybe when I get to my goal weight, which I have not decided what that was. When I first started out my weight loss journey, I wanted to be 190 pounds. That was my goal weight. But when I got down to 192, I was like, I want to go some more, because this is not how I want my body to look. And I thought at 190 that's how my body was going to look, but and I most definitely will have to invest in a tummy tuck. I'm afraid of them because people say they are so painful, but I am most definitely going to have to, because I have a lot of, that's one thing about me. I carried all my weight in my midsection. I have a very big stomach, and I know right now I have a lot of loose skin there from the weight that I have lost. And I know when I lose down more, it's going to be sagging even more. So I know most definitely I'm going to have it removed. You know, I mean, I don't have to. Maybe I could tone it and tuck it, but there's still going to be some extra loose skin. Far as, like, looking at it, and I hate looking at it right now. So I know when it gets to the point of sagging and looking like that, I probably will be like, oh, I'm disgusted by that. You know, so I don't know. We'll see. how it goes when it gets there. And I know you can do like working out with weights and things that will help tone and tighten your skin so that it's not so bad, because I've seen people who've done it who've had large abdomens and they worked out and their skin kind of, you know, stretched so it's not there. But I don't know if theirs was as big as mine, you know, so we'll see what happens in that category. And if I can, who knows, I don't know if I want to invest or if I'll be able to afford the tummy tuck, because it's not cheap whatsoever. It is not cheap. Insurance does not pay for any type of cosmetics unless there is a problem after having weight loss surgery. If you have a problem, now they will, sometimes the insurance companies will pay for to have that loose skin coming off, you know, like if it causes like rashes and you know, skin irritation, breakdown, and things like that. If it costs stuff like that, then sometimes the insurance company will help pay for that, and it won't be considered a cosmetic thing. Now, sometimes right now, I do, because that sweat, I know this is TMI. If it's TMI, y'all cut it off. Sometimes I do sweat under my stomach some, and sometimes I do have, like, a little irritation, redness there. But not so bad. I don't know if it's going to get worse as the weight loosens that skin. It's kind of touching skin. If it will be, I don't know. So we'll see when I get there to that point of it. But right now, I'm not anywhere near ready. I think I need to lose a lot more weight before I even think about talking about doing any kind of tummy tuck or anything. But like I said, I'm kind of fearful because I watched videos of people who had gastric bypass surgery and then they went back and got abdominoplasty and they looked like they were in so much pain. But after that general initial so much pain was over with, oh my God, they looked wonderful and they were happy about their results. So yeah, so I don't know. We'll see how it goes. That's in the future. Yeah. So, but hopefully, I'm hoping if I just need to get on track and stay focused so that, because I know it can be done. I watched this girl on Instagram, College Couponing, and she started like, I can't remember when she started. Maybe it was March. For some reason, March, April, something like that is sticking in my head. And when I look at her now, that girl looks good because she stayed focused. She worked out. She changed her eating habits. She found ways to make healthy recipes. She been making pizza crust out of cauliflower. And she just made all these healthy recipes. And it didn't take her a year to get that weight off of her. And she looks good. She's still working on it. But she actually looks wonderful. And so it can be done within a year. So I shouldn't say it's going to be years down the road, because it doesn't have to be. I just need to stay focused and know that I started this journey out on, you know, I didn't go through all of this to fall back. Like, I didn't go through all of the got a notice in that window. Being nosy driving, I know. But I didn't go through having gastric bypass and through this struggle of trying to lose this weight, and just to backtrack from where I started at. So that I try to remind myself daily, you know, you have got to do better than what you're doing so you can reach your goal. Yes, you lost weight. Yes, you know what I'm saying? I want to get to my goal where I'm satisfied at, and I got to push myself, because when I was 192, you know, I feel like I want to at least get back to 192, and then I can set new goals from there after I get there. So, yeah, so I'm striving hard to get back to my 192. I still have, like, what do I got? Eight? I got more than that. I'm calculating in my head. Still got like 30 pounds, I think, to get back there. Yeah, about 30 pounds. Might be a little more than 30 pounds to get back there. I have to go. My video's going to cut off now, but y'all remember to give God some praise. Give him some thanks for waking up this morning, starting you on your way, giving you another chance to get it right. It's always a blessing to be able to get it right. I will see you in my next video. Bye.